This is the unedited J.B. Pritzker, Rod Blagojevich, FBI wiretap. When Bruce Rauner released an unedited one-minute clip of the FBI wiretap between J.B. Pritzker and Rod Blagojevich, Pritzker didn't deny the conversation. He complained what was released wasn't the full conversation. What follows is the full, unedited, original FBI wiretap recordings obtained by the Chicago Tribune between Blagojevich and Pritzker. In it, you will hear Blagojevich discuss appointing Pritzker to Illinois' U.S. Senate seat. You will hear Blagojevich ask Pritzker for a large donation. And what you will not hear is Pritzker rule out an appointment. In these FBI recordings, you'll also hear Pritzker ask Blagojevich to appoint him state treasurer, repeatedly. You will hear Blagojevich and Pritzker discuss a scheme to appoint Pritzker attorney general. And you will hear Blagojevich and Pritzker discuss a dangerously corrupt deal with Mike Madigan to give Madigan Illinois' U.S. Senate seat in exchange for raising billions in higher taxes on Illinois. Pritzker said he wanted this wiretap to be released in full. Be careful what you ask for. The following conversation is in full, as recorded by the FBI and unedited. Viewer discretion is advised.
So I'd love to talk to you about, because I, you know, I'm sure you've got a lot of people who are throwing ideas, and I want to chat with you about that too. But I have something else I'm calling you about today, which is I just heard this morning that Alexei might get appointed to something in Washington. Have you heard that?
There was like a news report or something that was kind of mentioned, right?
Right.
I find that very hard to believe. I hear that Madigan is pushing Labor to try to push the Obama administration to put him in somewhere so they can clear the field for Lisa.
Oh, is that interesting?
And Madigan's dropping dimes on him because Resco is connected to the Broadway Bank, and the feds are looking at his bank. It's all Madigan's, how he operates.
Oh, wow.
So he's trying to get Lisa a clear field.
I see. So let me just throw some odd idea.
Uh-huh.
If it were true, what I heard, and it were real.
It could be. I mean, I'm just thinking that. I'm giving you my read on it.
Well I heard, what I heard was somebody who's close to Alexei.
Oh, hold on, JB. Hang on one second. Hang on. Hey, go ahead.
So I actually am calling you about, I think you appoint his replacement, don't you?
Ooh, interesting. Let's think about that. You interested in that?
That's the one I would want.
Now, here's a lot about this scenario.
It makes a lot of sense.
Listen, you're extremely open-minded on that. But don't rule yourself out completely on that Senate thing. That may not be... Look, you ought to see this list, huh?
I'm sure you got,
I've got a lot of factors to consider. I have to factor, you know, what do I want to do? Where am I going? You know, at some point I've got to support, you know, provide for my family. In a perfect world, provide for your family, do good, keep some sort of viability, and get back in the game at some point if there's any opportunity, but not at this level. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
If the Senate thing ever happened for you, my strong recommendation would be you got to do it and say you're running again. If you know, putting a guy like you there for just 2 years, I don't know. I mean,
I'm thinking about the political problem. And, the only way to make the political problem go away in that scenario would be, that I can think of, is to say he's not running for re-election, which doesn't do anybody any good, so it's probably not a good scenario.
No.
The treasurer thing's a different thing.
Yeah. Oh, you did. This is a good option. Keep going. Talk to me.
Putting a business person in a business person's job.
Yep.
I think I would be able to get people like Bill Brodsky at the CBOE and people like Terry Duffy at the... at the Merck to sort of stand up independently and say, we're suggesting to the governor that this is a good idea. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah. Listen, I think it's exciting.
I haven't called either one of those guys to ask them to do that. It's a brand new idea here. But I throw that out at you. And finally, look, even if none of those things make sense for you, I'd love to help you in any way I can, you know, with any decision making you decide to, you know, that you're going to get involved in. You know, I, for whatever it's worth, you know, some of the players I know, and I would be happy to act as a little bit as an intermediary with the people that you don't want to have it or the people you do want to have it or whatever. So I just offer myself and my service to you.
Okay, but what do you do if you're me, okay? And, you know, I don't give a what these in the media say. I really believe we've done great things for people in Illinois. This Obama ran on my record, okay? He said he brought health care to kids. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? He voted for it. You know, he's talking about a, you know, a capital bill and expanding health care for working families. We've done 700,000 people have gotten it. He's talking about not raising taxes.
The only reason to do it is if he'll appoint you to something.
Well, but listen, well, I guess that's an, yeah, you know, but he and I were tonied up. He'd probably like to keep, you know, that's another fucking thing that's so galling. No one will love Tony longer than me. Okay, so, but what if, and I'm telling you, this could happen, because I know how Madigan is. He says, I'll give you health care, I'll give you a capital bill, okay? I'll balance the, what works with you, to balance the budget the way you want to do it. I raise taxes on people, and you make Lisa the senator. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
That puts me in a moral dilemma. Because of all of the prospective candidates, what dealing with her, suing us to f***ing support Bush kicking 35,000 poor people off of health care.
Yeah, I know.
You know, all that
do it. You should do it. I'd take that.
Morally repugnant. I'd probably have to do it.
I'd do it.
Okay? And then there's an AG I can appoint, JB.
You're doing the right thing for the people.
Are you a lawyer?
Yeah.
There's an AG that I appoint.
Oh, that's it.
You see what I'm saying?
Oh, there you go.
I mean, don't rule that one out.
Okay.
I mean, I'm not promising. I'm just saying these are all scenarios. What?
A lot of things to think about. Let's continue the conversation another time because I got to run into this thing.
All right.
But, Rod, I really, you know, and look, I don't want to seem like I'm, you know, out here looking for a job. Honestly, I'd like to help you, and I also think there's probably a, you know, something I might be able to do. But the treasurer thing actually seems totally logical to me and not harmful to you.
If he does that, I'll call you right away. If he ends up going there, I'll call you right away. And we'll talk about it seriously and get focused.
All right, man.
But there's other options. Don't rule them out. I mean, I'm not promising anything, but you're, in my mind, you're there somewhere.
Well, you're kind. All right.
Okay. I'll see you. All right, bye.
So, you know, one thing I wanted to say was there's absolutely no reason for you to do this. And so I'm not going to ask you to do it. Only that, as I, you know, you and I talked about it for 5 seconds, that my interest in holding public office is, you know, always large.
Lay it on me, man. Go ahead. I mean,
No.
I'm not going to rule it out. Go ahead.
No, but I, you know, I think there are issues, obviously, that are problematic for you about doing it.
If I appointed you, I can't run again. So consider that.
Yeah.
Okay?
So
that's not necessarily this is not an option I'm going to preclude, though.
No, I got you. I'll tell you why. There's only one reason that it could work, and then I'm going to drop it because I'm not really that interested in it. I'm not. The only reason I can think of that would work is if you appointed me to serve out the term but not run for re-election. You know, in other words, if the announcement was, you know, that you're doing this because it's a good government move, because it's, you know, this is going to be a terrible couple of years that you need somebody with financial expertise. Someone who's above politics and not, you know, and not running for it and not beholden to anybody, and, you know, whose only interest is in fixing the economy and so on. That's the only argument. So I'd leave you with that. I agree with you. I think it's a problematic for the press and everybody else. They'll look for something even if there's nothing there.
Right. Having said, can I jump in here, though?
Yeah.
If you know, look, don't misread this, but you got, in my mind, you'd have a much better chance than, let's say, Jan, okay? And don't repeat that, okay?
Yeah.
And if this isn't as far-fetched as it might seem, and no one's speculating on you at all. And I thought about this. I mean, I tease you a little bit, but I thought about it a little bit. And again, for me, it would be, are you not going to run again? And then, you know, what? How do I get out there in a post-governor's environment and be viable in some respects where I can get back on the stage, not state? Did I lose you, JB?
I mean, I have thought a lot about that since you and I talked. And I mean, I have to say, I think it makes political sense for both of us.
Oh, no. Look, I think this would be great.
Yeah.
I mean, I have no problem with that.
The pitch, you know, the pitch for you, I think, is, you're picking, you know.
Banking and financial experience and know-how and all of that, right?
Yeah, I don't know about banking, right?
Cause yeah, but financial know-how.
You throw my sister in Superior Bank in.
What happened to her bank? She get a collapse or something?
Yeah, she was chairman of a bank, and it had subprime loans. I mean, it's all the bad stuff, you know.
Superior Bank turned out to be an inferior bank.
Inferior, exactly. Very good. I like that, Inferior Bank. I haven't thought about that. That's a good one. Anyway, so yeah, but I was nothing to do with that, so that's not going to be my problem. But no, I think my problem, the only problem I can come up with for you, I got a lot of reasons why it makes sense. The problem for you would be, same problem with the Senate, really. I've given you contributions.
No.
And what's that?
Oh, I'm sorry to cut you off. Go ahead, JP.
No, go ahead. What?
No, total non-issue. Well, first of all, you give money to everybody, like Lisa Madigan, okay?
Yeah. No.
Which, incidentally, if you can do for me what you did for her before the end of the year, can you think about that?
Mm-hmm.
But
well, I can't do. I mean, not while everything's up in the air. But I hear you. Yeah.
Okay.
I hear you. And
or, yeah.
But anyway,
if we go in that direction, though, if that does happen,
yeah.
I mean, there's some other people who can help us that you know.
Sure.
If you feel skittish about that, which I believe you shouldn't, but go ahead.
Yeah, I don't think we should even talk about it.
All right, fine.
I understand what you're saying.
Okay.
You know, assuming no legal problems.
Oh yeah.
Assume,
right.
You know, that your pitch is going to be, look, I, you know, with all the other crap that you could say here, you know, I've done real things.
Right.
And so I think you've got a lot to run on. It's just, you know, we got to get the legal thing behind you.
Right.
You know, that's for sure.
Right.
And I don't know.
Yeah, but there are statutes of limitations and things, and those dates are running.
Mm-hmm.
And those things will come and go long before there's a re-election.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah.
Soon?
Yeah. And then
okay.
And then it'll just fade away.
Mm-hmm.
And then you can say it.
This has been the unedited J.B. Pritzker, Rod Blagojevich, FBI wiretap. J.B. Pritzker asked for it, and you got it. The full, unedited FBI tapes of J.B. Pritzker asking Blagojevich for Illinois' state treasurer seat, of Blagojevich scheming to appoint Pritzker attorney general, and of Blagojevich and Pritzker arguing to give away a U.S. Senate seat to Mike Madigan in exchange for a deal to raise billions in taxes on Illinois. But there's more, so much more. Go to PritzkerBlago.com to hear more recordings from the FBI investigation. This has been the unedited J.B. Pritzker, Rod Blagojevich, FBI wiretap.